going to start with the poem Legend of Northland, as we have started it yesterday. And what we have observed about the area which is mostly covered with snow. So Legend of Northland, what is this poem is all about? The poem is written by the poet Phoebe Cary, and in this poem the poet is telling about a legend which was prevalent in that region of Northland, where Northland is situated in the extreme, you can say, Arctic region, where most of the time it is covered with snow. People used to remain and confined to their homes only. They are not coming out, and they are using sledges, using or harnessing the power of reindeers in order to move from one place to another. Right? So, first two paragraphs we have done yesterday, but again, let us have the revision of these. Away, away in the Northland. Away, away, this is an example of alliteration. Moreover, this is an example of repetition. So away, away in the Northland, where the hours of the day are few, where the hours of the day are few means where the days are short and nights are longer. And the nights are so long in winter that they cannot sleep them through. And the nights, they are so long that it is difficult for people to sleep for longer time. So then and during that time, they have to pass on their time. Now, in this case, first paragraph, the last two lines, what are these telling us? These last two lines, these are telling us the daily routine of the people of Northland. Moreover, the literary device, the poetic device which is used here is enjambment. What is enjambment? When there is no punctuation mark at the end of the line and the idea of the line, it is carried forward to the next line, then this is an example of enjambment. So, where they utilize the power or energy of the reindeer in order to move their sledges. To the sledges, they use reindeers to run their sledges, and students are still entering, I don't know why. When it snows, it is difficult to walk on snow, and people are using reindeers in order to move the sledges. And the children look like beer cups. Look like word is used. So this is an example of what? This is an example of simile. And the children, they are looking like beer cups. They are looking like the young ones of bears. Why? Because bear is a furry animal, and in their funny furry clothes. Funny furry is repetition of the sound FF, and again this is an example of alliteration. So they are looking funny in their furry clothes, and they are always covering themselves up in their woolen clothes. So the poet wants to deliver to us through these two paragraphs the kind of life, the kind of atmosphere prevalent there. So, they tell them a curious story. I don't believe this true. This means it is a, you can say, short form use for it is. Okay? So, otherwise, if we write down it is in this form, it will be considered as wrong. But the poet is using it. So, this is an example of poetic license. When the poet can make alterations, or the poet can make changes in the words. So, where they harness a swift reindeer to the sledges when it snows, they tell them a curious story. So, people of Northland, they used to tell their children a story. But I don't believe it is true. But the poet is saying, I don't believe that this story is true. And yet you may learn a lesson if I tell the tale to you. And the poet is saying, but definitely you will learn a lesson. This poem is delivering a lesson, and definitely you will learn a lesson if I will tell you the story, which is commonly prevalent and during the region or in the region of Northland. So again, in this paragraph, the last two lines, and yet you may learn a lesson if I tell the tale to you. So what is this? This is also an example of enjambment. What is this? This is also an example of enjambment. So now here goes the story. So let us see what is the story here. Once, when the good Saint Peter lived in the world below. So the poet is saying, this is the time. This is the time when there lived a Saint Peter. Saint Peter, here, saint, you know, the person who is endowed with godly qualities, who is always doing good work for the people, and who is always preaching. So here, saint, you know who is a saint, and Peter, it is a name taken from Bible. It is means Bible, or it is a biblical theme. Okay, so when a reference is made from a famous book or about a famous character from some famous book, this is called as allusion. I'm writing here, this is called as allusion. So what is the literary device here it is used? This is an example of allusion. So what is allusion? Let me explain once again. When a reference to a famous character is made from a famous book or popular book, it is called as allusion. So here Peter, okay, Saint Peter. Peter is a name which is referring from Bible. Okay, it is referring from Bible. So this is the reason why it is called as allusion. Lived in the world below. Lived in the world below means that Saint Peter lived, where lived he lived? He lived in the world below. He lived in the Northland, in the low-lying areas, and walked about it preaching. So preaching means teaching of religious practices. Okay, so what is preaching? Preaching means teaching of religious practices. So, and walked about it preaching just as he did, you know. So, and he is moving from one place to another, going from one place to another, preaching the people, telling them of the religious practices, all the good qualities of human being, what God wants, and why God has sent them to this earth. And just as he did, you know, and this was his daily job, this was his daily work that he was doing. So here in the last two lines, again, enjambment is there, although there is comma after preaching. Okay, right? This is an example of enjambment. So, okay, he came to the door of a cottage in traveling round the earth. So, while preaching, while moving from one place to another, so what happened? So, what happened that one day he came to the door of a cottage. He came to a cottage and knocked at the door in traveling round the earth. He was moving from one place to another. He was traveling round the earth, and he came to that cottage where a little woman was making cakes. Little woman means the woman was not, you can say, long in height. She was short-heighted. She was making cakes and baking them on the hearth. What is hearth? It is furnace. It is furnace. where after kindling fire, the things can be baked because of extreme hot temperature there. So there, what the woman was doing in the house was that the woman was baking the cakes. And where she was baking the cakes? She was baking the cakes in the hearth, okay, in the furnace. And being faint with fasting, this is again F and F alliteration. He was faint with fasting means he was tired. He was, you can say, completely tired. And because of this, he was feeling himself to be fainted. So he was faint with fasting because he had not eaten anything throughout the day. And this is the reason why he was feeling to be fainted. For the day was almost done. Day was almost done. What it means? Can anybody tell? What is the meaning of day almost done? Yes. Just a moment. Yes, Ramni.
Yes, ma'am. Day was over.
Yes, the day was over. Right. So the day was almost done. It means that the day was over and it was evening time, right? He asked her from her store of cakes to give him a single one. So naturally, he knocked at the door. When he knocked at the door, the woman, what did he see? He saw that the woman was baking cakes in the furnace. So the smell of the freshly baked cakes, it tempted and it also, you can say, evoked more hunger of Saint Peter. And he asked that old woman to give him what? To give him a small cake so that he can eat it and can satiate his hunger. Okay, quench his thirst. Okay, so in the same manner for hunger, you use satiate. In order to satiate his hunger. So Saint Peter, he has come to a house where a woman was baking the cakes and he wanted to eat one cake because throughout the day he was moving from one place to another. He has not eaten anything. So in order to satiate his hunger, he was hungry. He wanted to eat something. So for that, he told the woman to give him a piece of cake. So let us see what the woman will do. So now let us see what she will do. So she made a very little cake. Yes, the woman did not deny. No, I won't give the cake. What she did, she made a very little cake. She made a very small cake. But as it baking lay, she looked at it and thought it seems too large to give away. So what she did, she baked a very small piece of cake. So she put it into the hearth, into the furnace, and you know the cakes, they used to become fluffy. Okay, they turn out to be fluffy, right? When they turn out to be fluffy, when they are baked, because baking soda is used in their preparation. So it turned out to be fluffy. The woman thought, no, this is really very large cake. Why should I give this cake to the saint? She thought it is too large for him. So it should not be given away, she thought. So she thought, I should put this cake on the side for me, for my eating, for my consumption, and I will give some other piece of cake. I will bake another piece of cake for the saint in order to give away. Therefore, she needed another and still a smaller one. Then she kneaded it. You know, kneading is the process of making the dough. Okay. She kneaded another and still a smaller one. So she took another piece of, you can say some amount of flour. She kneaded the dough and prepared the complete dough. And ultimately, she took a very smaller one, smaller than the previous one. Okay. But it looked, when she turned it over, as large as the first had done. And what she has noticed, that it is again of the same size. As it was earlier that she has made. So here in this line, the last line, as large as, comparison, using like or as. So this is again an example of simile. Okay, so this is what? This is an example of simile. So then she took a very small piece of dough. She baked another cake. She thought to give it to the saint. But what happened? But when she looked at it, she thought it is as big as the previous one. So again, she was greedy in nature. As she was greedy in nature, she thought, no, I won't give this one to Saint Peter also, because this is again too large to be given away. Because she is greedy, she never wanted to give her part, or she did not want to give what she is having to other people. She did not want to share her things. She thought, why should I give this one to Saint Peter? Then she took a tiny scrap of dough. Tiny scrap means very small amount, just negligible amounts. Then she took a tiny scrap of dough, rolled it flat. Here, rolled is an example of repetition, and baked it thin as a wafer. And moreover, this is also an example of enjambment. Right? What is this? This is also an example of enjambment. So how it is an example of enjambment? See, and rolled it flat and baked it thin as a wafer. So the idea of this line, rolled and baked it thin as a wafer, it is rolled onto the next line. So this is again an example of enjambment. So what is this? This is an example of enjambment. But she couldn't part with that. She thought she should not be separated from this piece of cake too. She should not give away this piece of cake to Saint Peter. Why? Because she was greedy, she did not want to give her piece of cake to Saint Peter. So, for she said, my cakes that seem too small when I eat of them myself and are yet too large to give away. So till here, which literary device used here? Raise up your hands, come on. Which literary device used here? Can anybody tell? Yes, Dia. Yes.
Enjambment, because the idea is divided into three lines.
Absolutely right. It is an example of enjambment. Why it is an example of enjambment? Because see, that the line, it is the idea which is enclosed in this line, that my cakes that seem too small when I eat of them myself and yet too large to give away. So the idea is carried forward to the next line, that my cakes, they are really very small. They are too small when I eat of them myself. They are very small if I eat them, but if I give them to somebody, what this shows? This shows that she was quite greedy in nature. She is having inhuman qualities. She did not want to help others. She did not want to be a server of humanity. Okay, so what she did, she thought that her cakes, they are too small when she eats them on her own, but they are too large if to be given to somebody else. So she put them on the shelf. So what she did, she put all the cakes on the shelf. She was not ready to give any piece of cake that she had baked so far to Saint Peter. She thought that she should not give these pieces of cake to Saint Peter because they are too large to be given away. But she thought they are too small for her. So she kept them for her own consumption. Now, Saint Peter, who was looking at the woman, at her ex, what she was doing. She baked one cake, put it aside. Then she baked another cake. Again, she put it aside. Then she baked third cake and again she put it aside. So, what is this? Ultimately, this evoked some reaction in Saint Peter. He must have shown some kind of reaction because on one side, he was feeling hungry. Okay, and you know that when your hunger is not fulfilled, you will definitely get angered. Okay, so let us see what Saint Peter did. Then good Saint Peter grew angry. But obvious, he must have grown angry. He grew angry and for he was hungry and faint. For he was hungry and faint because I told you that he was hungry for much time. And he was also feeling himself on the verge of being fainted. Why? Because throughout the day, he was walking from one place to another in order to give his sermons, in order to preach people. Right? So, and surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. Provoke means an act to make someone someone's anger arouse. Okay, so and surely, what happened? This kind of woman, she's enough to provoke a saint. That she is provoking the anger. She is provoking the saint that he should do something. He should speak something. Okay. So the first line. See, then good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was hungry and faint. Again, the first line, it is related to the next line. So this is what? This is again an example of enjambment. Okay? So again, this is an example of enjambment. So let me repeat all the literary devices used here. So right from the starting so that you can have the revision. First line, away is an example of alliteration. And moreover, this is also an example of repetition. Then, after that, the last two lines, and the nights are so long in winter that they cannot sleep them through. This is an example of enjambment. Then the next paragraph also, that where they harness the swift reindeer to the sledges when it snows, this is again an example of enjambment. And the next line also. And the children look like bears' cubs in their funny, furry clothes. This is again an example of enjambment. Moreover, look like bears' cubs is simile. And funny, furry is an example of what? Alliteration. Next paragraph. And yet, And yet you may learn a lesson if I tell the tale to you. This is again an example of enchantment. What is this? This is an example of enchantment. And Tistu means it is poetic license. Yes, the name of the reference of Saint Peter, as it is related to a biblical theme. So this is an example of allusion. A-double-L-U-S-I-O-N. What is allusion? Allusion is the making a reference to the famous character or to the famous name from a famous book is called allusion. Then, next page. Yes. So she made a very small cake. See here. Then she took a tiny scrap and rolled it flat and baked it thin as a wafer. This is also an example of enchantment. And the first line, for she said, my cakes that seem too small when I eat of them myself, is an example of enchantment. And then good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was faint. This is again an example of enchantment, right? So I hope that all these poetic devices are clear to you. And tomorrow we will see that in anger, let us see what Saint Peter will do to the woman and what lesson did she learn? Now just raise up your hands if you have any doubts with you so that I can solve your queries. Yes, you can ask me your questions.